of the 19 years of her career. She handles large account management at Baina. A mother of two children, she passionately pursues her hobbies of tracking and Indian classical dance. Most of her international travel has been through her work. Incidentally, the first one was to Egypt. Today she will talk about ancient world civilization and walk us through her recent trip to Turkey.
Hi friends, welcome. We're not all of us here by accident. We've come here by way of evolution and loads of luck. How did we actually get here? About 13 billion years ago, we saw a massive explosion out of nowhere. Energy and matter exploded to form the universe. About 4.5 billion years ago, we saw a solar system getting created. About 3.8 billion years ago, Earth was already supporting basic forms of life. About 225 million years ago, we saw the Pangaea, which was a supercontinent, start breaking up. Some millions of years passed by, but we're still nowhere in the picture. About 200,000 years ago, we make our first appearance. Well, I'm not sure how many of us look like that still. We went through what is known as the Stone Age. Several thousand years of those. In fact, 240,000 years of the Stone Age. So if we compare it to where we are today, it actually constituted 90% of our human existence on the Earth. About 10,000 years ago, the Ice Age ended. And what we saw was the emergence of civilization actually take place, where from hunter-gatherers, we moved to actually an agriculture-based society, which meant we could stay in a permanent place for longer periods of time. This was called the Neolithic period, after which followed the Bronze Age, and then it followed the Iron Age. Why all this? Because all of this really is the backdrop of ancient civilizations of the world. If you look at ancient civilizations, what typically is termed as a period is about 3300 BC to about 500 AD or about 600 AD, depending on the fall of the Roman Empire or the advent of Islam. Let's take a very quick look at some of the ancient civilizations that have spread through the world. We saw early Egypt, we saw the Indus Valley, and these are all in sequential order. We saw Sumer much before that. We saw a very, very strong period of about 400 years when a lot of civilizations came up in the Mesopotamian area. And essentially, they came up in what is called as the cradle of civilization. And Turkey forms a big part in that cradle of civilization because it was one of the most fertile valleys at that time. I recently did a road trip to Turkey, and these are actually my own pictures from the places I visited. Cappadocia, essentially, is a place that has seen human beings exist right from the Neolithic age, to the Hittite era, to the Persian, Greek, Romans, Byzantine, Turkish, and then later the Ottoman period. Some of these pictures actually are of the valleys and the mountains that you see there, which have formed because of volcanoes. And a lot of that is because human life was possible there because of the soft rock. So you can see caves having been carved out there with soft rock, even by the most primitive tools of old ancient human beings. And a lot of the villages that I visited today continue to live inside the caves. My hotel was actually inside the cave. The other place that I took a peek into was this underground city, which was formed about 4,000 years ago, okay, which again goes way back before the Iron Age, Bronze Age. And this particular city has been built 180 meters underground. It has got 8 stories of people who lived underground in that particular area called Derinkeu in Cappadocia again. Initially built by the Stone Age people, but later on used as a refuge in the war times. An entire village of about 40,000 people could go and live in that city during war times. Pamukkale, again a region in Anatolia, has been developed over 11,000 years because of limestones and hot water mineral springs. So you find actually the landscape here of terraces being formed, and these were the spas earlier. Now there are different kind of spas being used here. But starting in 3rd century, BC, the Romans and the Greeks built what is known as the Necropolis, or the City of Dead, followed by the Hierapolis, which was a city of joy. And these were large civilizations that had taken place in this area of Anatolia, actually. Ephesus in the region of Seljuk, again, saw a very large city, and most of the city actually today is prevalent. You have a grand theater here which could seat about 75,000 people. With technology, even without mics, you could have a person's voice being heard by all those 75,000 people at that time. And actually, invaders came in, so from Greeks, Persians, Romans, later to the Byzantine era, you saw all of the people come and live here. That essentially is the end of my presentation. My last slide was in Istanbul, which again talks about the eras that have been there in that particular region. Thank you.